Now, if I don't know anything about it, I didn't do my homework, but this flag, which you can see the wind is very, very strong, says POWMIA. I assume that's prisoner of war, missing in action, and have probably been involved in some of those searches. There's another one docked here. This was here even when the Normandy came in. The USS Kaufman, FFG 59. Here, along with us, you're seeing a good view of the USS Normandy CG 60 on this cold, wind chill factor cold morning. If you look closely through the opening, you can see the USS flag on the inside wall. And they have the red, white, and blue banner on the outside. They're working very hard since they came in. Vanguard of Victory will be going in for the program. The Nazis 60, the commissioning information. This is the post command office. This is what the CG Normandy is known for in commemoration.
He's only about
this strong. The landing. I'm going to scan what we saw when we came into the command post building. He's talking with Trish. Okay, this little gal is Patricia. And I'm from Bath, Maine, in the group. That's Lieutenant Hill. The officer in Normandy.
Okay, we're up in the area on the deck.
Where
the
She's gonna take you to Hollywood here. There you go. Let me get him.
Bush. He always has a ticket mouth.
Yes.
Right. Thank you.
You put a grin almost, you know?
It's kind of
mischievous look.
Yeah.
I would like to see Bush in person. I really would. I'd like to see President Bush in person. Maybe someday. She's a mate on board. And easy for the guests, of course. That Marine Detachment.
Oh,
local National Guard personnel. And the Color Guard. There's one of the helicopter pads that goes out when the helicopter comes in and then it's pulled back in on that track. The area that we're in accommodates two helicopters and there it is right in our little boat. Your ship's crew are assembled. We're just going to talk to Dave and the police back in there. And these couple of men that you see, civilian clothes, they are actually Vietnam War and Korean War veterans, as well as some of them Pearl Harbor.
Order! country on December 7th, 1944. Please join me now with the invocation provided by Father Soutier, Chaplain for United States Navy.
Ethel Lesher was born in Erie, Pennsylvania, graduated 7th of class of 581 in 1939 from the Naval Academy. During World War II, Ethel Lesher participated
in this chapter. This is a distinct honor to be able to represent Joe Taussig on this significant day. Joe Taussig has always been one of my personal heroes. I have been looking forward to having him here and my having the chance to hear his remarks. What should we, the crew of Normandy and citizens of the United States, learn from this tragic event? Let's look at it first as a military occurrence and a major joint exercise concentrated on surprise attacks on Pearl Harbor by aircraft coming from carriers attacking from the northwest. From Vice Admiral Halsey with the Pacific Fleet aircraft carriers sailed midway against possible Japanese attack. He put his forces in full battle readiness, full condition watch, with orders to fire on any Japanese forces met. Despite all these war maneuvers and actions, the U.S. forces at Pearl Harbor were not ready on 7 December. And nearly 12 hours after the attack at Pearl Harbor, when the Japanese came in on Clark Air Base, all the aircraft there were still in an anti-sabotage dispersal and were destroyed on the ground. The lessons to be learned from these sad facts are that it is the business of national security to look at capabilities.
Normandy, present! Halt!
Thank you.
Don't look now. Don't look now.
But the other windows,
very good perspective when you're in the way.
Window wide.
Been bored.
Just
captain
the chair.
Yeah, I've been in that. And none of us do it, even when there's no one here, no one wants it.
You know, when you're looking down at the water, it gives you the feeling that you're moving because of the current.
Well, we are moving a bit. You notice there's a fairly decent list. If you look back up here, much of a roll, and up this way, we have one.
Ready to go to sleep again?
So it can tell the ship's doing good.
I see.
Now,
okay,
you can take about a 45-degree roll without hurting anything, but after that, it would start coming out and fall off automatically, and everything falls off, so that we can steady back up again.
Where are you sitting? Where were you sitting when you came in the channel? Where were you sitting?
I stationed here behind this chart table over there. It's a bar table. That's where I lay out all my charts.
Give them my group familiar faces from last night. Hi. Hope you enjoy your study section. We have an officer in the deck, a counting officer, as well as a TACO, guy that handles our comms for us. We have our helmsman and lee helmsman, our quartermaster of the watch, the fellow this guy. Kept the console. It's pretty easy, which we never really use other than my patrols. I'm not from an navigation system. We have a Loran Charlie. If any of you people have sailboats or motorboats, you may have a Loran Charlie system aboard. We also have an Omega receiver down in your chart room. So we have those three systems, as well as the old sextant. We get out there and shoot stars. We're out of sea. You can see our readouts there once we get to the bright bridge. A little TV monitor up there. We can monitor.
Very pleasant up here.
It is pleasant.
Thank you.
The State Troopers Union says they should. Good evening, I'm Debbie Ferrara. Karen Adams is off.
And I'm Walter Cryan. Yesterday, Stone and Ventures in North today, Japan attacked U.S. military bases in Hawaii. It was war. Today in Newport, that war and those who died in it were remembering. A story from Channel 12's Phil Wilson.
December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy.
Japan's sneak attack against Pearl Harbor swept the United States into World War II. Today in Newport, those Americans killed at Pearl Harbor were remembered during a ceremony aboard the Navy's newest ship, the guided missile cruiser USS Normandy.
Our battles were poor and remembered themselves. All those who died at Pearl Harbor in Hawaii on the 7th of December, 1941.
The main speaker talked of how the attack on Pearl Harbor united the nation.
Pearl Harbor galvanized that country's unity and all our efforts as no other event could possibly have done.
The Admiral noted the current historic events in Eastern Europe, nations shedding themselves of communism. But he warned the U.S. military must be ever vigilant.
Today, like a neighbor scared by a criminal gang, we can breathe easier with the gang apparently disbanded. But the police must still be on patrol, trained and ready.
In Newport, Bill Wilson, Channel 12 Eyewitness News.